Hello everybody, this is Dr. Arun Kannan, orthopedic surgeon from Apollo Main Hospital, Greams Road, Chennai. Today I would like to share with you my thoughts on the latest treatments in knee osteoarthritis. Knee osteoarthritis is a very common problem, especially in people 50 years or over. Knee osteoarthritis is basically degradation of the cartilage which is there in the knee joint. The cartilage is a lining on top of the bones. You could have seen, like when you take a chicken bone, you could have seen that the end is very smooth and shiny. That is what we call cartilage. With age and with certain other factors, the cartilage gets worn out. It's a wear and tear problem in the knee joint. So this is what is called osteoarthritis. Now there are two important causes of osteoarthritis that we can modify and control. One is weight or body weight, the next is our activities. So the more body weight we have, there is more strain on the knees. So the number one factor to alter when you have knee osteoarthritis to slow down the progression is weight reduction. So how will you know how much weight to lose? There is a index called BMI. It is a body mass index. It gives a ratio of how much you weigh relative to your height. You can easily calculate it online. There are multiple calculators. So anybody with a BMI over 25 with knee arthritis should do weight reduction, and they will definitely benefit from it. The best way to reduce weight is through a proper diet program that will help you reduce weight, at the same time maintain proper nutrition in the body. We generally use our dietitians and give a proper diet program so that they can help reduce weight as well as maintain nutrition for the whole body as well as for the knee joint. Second thing that I want to say is, lot of people have this thing called a bow leg deformity. It is very common. People may not notice it when you go for an army selection or something, people notice it, but generally it is not noticed. Bow leg means when you keep your feet together, there will be a gap between the knees. This is very common problem, and lot of people with arthritis also have this. So when you have bow legs, what happens is there is more stress on the inner part of the knee joint, and this leads to osteoarthritis. If you have bow legs, there are very important activity modifications that you can do to relieve this excess pressure. I'll show you a few of them. One is called this out-toe gait. So when you walk, keep your feet pointed outwards. This is one important way wherein you can avoid excess pressure on the inner part of the knee joint. The second thing is, keep the knee close to the midline of the body. Especially when you are going up and down stairs, you can keep your knee outward or inward. Keep it close to the other knee when you are climbing stairs. This also helps to reduce the strain on the inner part of the knee joint. So these are two important but simple measures that you can do yourself. When you are walking, keep your feet pointed a little bit outward. When you are climbing stairs, keep the knee joint close to the midline of the body, or you can imagine towards the opposite knee. Take it towards the opposite knee. Next, we generally prescribe a set of exercises for all patients with osteoarthritis. This improves the muscle strength, gives better balance for the knee as well as the hip, and this can reduce pressure on one part of the knee joint and equally distribute pressure. The other modification is in the shoe wear. So we give something called a lateral wedge heel, wherein there is a slight elevation on the outer part of the foot. So this can be worn along with any of the shoes that you use, or you can make it as a chappal specially made for you, a custom made chappal you can call it. When you use this, again it helps to evenly distribute pressure in people with bow legs. So all these: weight reduction, modification of your activities, and simple exercises along with minor changes in the chappal or shoe can help to reduce the stress on the knee joint. So in early to moderate stages of arthritis, when the degradation is not very severe, we also use something called a PRP injection. In PRP injection, we take certain amount of blood like 15 ml or 20 ml from you, process it to concentrate the growth factors. This is again injected back into the knee joint to help with regeneration of the cartilage. However, this works best when we combine it with the other measures that I told before: weight reduction, activity modification, exercises, and modification of footwear. When this is combined with PRP injection, then the PRP injection works quite well. If you are extremely heavy, you don't want to reduce weight, and if you put PRP, it may not work well by itself. So what we now concentrate is something called a multimodal treatment for knee osteoarthritis. This has been a very useful measure over the last few years, wherein we combine multiple treatments, multiple simple treatments along with PRP in mild to moderate cases, gives excellent results. However, if you have severe stages of knee arthritis, then you may be left with only an option of a knee replacement. There is severe knee arthritis, it can be seen easily on x-ray, there will be no gap between the bones. So it is bone on bone arthritis, we call it. So in this stage, you may not be able to walk much. So if you are having severe pain, cannot walk more than 15-20 minutes, and if there are changes on x-ray that are compatible with severe osteoarthritis, then we are looking at only a knee replacement. It can be either a partial knee replacement or a full knee replacement, depending on how the damage is. So in short, in mild to moderate stages, simple measures work very well. Weight reduction, activity modification, exercises, small changes in the footwear, this can be combined with PRP injection to give very good results. However, if you are in the severe stage, then you are looking at either a partial knee replacement or a total knee replacement. Thank you.